Now we are going to place the Bible, Holy Rosary, and the crucifix on the caskets of Tony and Sara. Thank you.
Let us pray.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that, through this mystery, your servants, Tony and Sara Zendejas, who have gone to their rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated. Now we have the liturgy of the word. The first reading is going to be read. Please listen to the God's word attentively. Thank you all.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ, Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On one occasion, Jesus spoke this: I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise, and the land, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, friends. My friends in Christ Jesus, first and foremost, I would like to express my deepest hearty condolences to all the family of Zendejas, friends, relatives who are gathered here. May God be with you all in these difficult times. May the Spirit of God comfort and console you all, and Mary, your mother, be with you and strengthen your hearts at this the few times that you are going through at the loss of your beloved dad and beloved mom. My friends in Christ Jesus, every one of us are created with a specific purpose in our life. All of us came into this world with a purpose, with a mission. And the purpose of God creating all of us is to know God, to love God, to serve God, and to reach Him at the end of our life. That is the ultimate goal of our life. To love God, to know God, to serve God, and to reach Him at the end of our life. No matter what we do here on earth, and that is what at the end of our life we all have to depart from this world and reach God. Right? My friends in Christ Jesus, it is rare occasions we see, you know, both husband and wife, died together in a few days later and have a funeral mass together. And it is the God's will. It is the God's will that that they share that life after death, even as they have shared their life together here on earth almost for 63 years. And they have journeyed again to the eternal home together. My friends in Christ Jesus, as I have read the obituary of Tony and Sara, I was really thrilled to know that they had such a wonderful life, such a amazing, great life. As God has blessed Tony and Sara with wonderful children, seven children. Alice, Tony, Daniel, Valerie, Paul, Julian, Michael. And God has blessed them with 27. God has blessed them with 21 grandchildren and 7 great grandchildren, right? Such a great number. Now you have a big family, right? And God has blessed them. My friends in Christ Jesus, Tony and Sarah have journeyed together as a married couple for 63 years. I believe it is because the grace of God was working in their life. And they allowed the grace of God to work in their life. And therefore, God blessed them, their married lives, to be so fruitful and so successful. And my friends in Christ Jesus. And that is the message that they give through their life to each and every one of us gathered here. As we, as Tony and Sarah, allow the Spirit of God to work in their life, and you and I are called to allow that Spirit of God to work in our life, thus we may have a happy and joyful and fruitful life as those two couples have enjoyed their life here on earth. My friends in Christ Jesus, both Tony and Sarah loved God wholeheartedly, and they kept God in their life. They kept God as their center of their life. And now, as I have read their obituary, and I know that Sarah and Tony have prayed together the Holy Rosary, said their prayers every day, and have come together to participate in this in the Holy Mass every Sunday here at St. Patrick's until the before COVID hit. My friends in Christ Jesus, in anyone's life, that life to be more fruitful, we need to keep God in our life. And we see in today's readings, you know, the St. Paul very beautifully telling to all of us that, you know, death has no power over him. No, we know that Christ raised from the dead and he dies no more, right? We all, as the Christians, as Catholics, we all believe that Jesus Christ has come into this world with a purpose, with a special mission, that was to save all of us from the bondage of slavery of sin and give us that gift of eternal life, salvation to all of us. And all those who have baptized share in the death and resurrection of Jesus. Both Tony and Sarah have shared in the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And they believed Jesus as their Savior. They believed that Jesus as their Redeemer. They believed that Jesus has come into this world and he died for them. And through his passion, death and resurrection, he gives us that gift of eternal life. My friends in Christ Jesus, as Jesus has promised us, in the John's Gospel, we know that, Jesus tells, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though they die, they will live forever, right? And everyone who lives and believes in him will never die. My friends in Christ Jesus, Tony and Sarah believe in Jesus Christ and accepted that gospel in their life. And that's a beautifully they have remembered to keep the Bible and the crucifix and the casket is a reminder for all of us that that word of God is nothing but Jesus himself. And that crucifix always reminds that Jesus' love for each and every one of us. And they kept that cross in their life. And the beautiful gospel that we have just read, Jesus inviting all of us, come to me, all who are carrying heavy burdens, and I will take away and I will give you the rest that you need. My friends in Christ Jesus, Tony and Sarah have embraced Jesus in their life, and finally they have gone to the rest into the kingdom of God. My friends, death is not the end of our life. For the Christians, for the Catholics, we all believe that there is a life after death. There is a life after death, and that you and I are striving for that eternal life. And Jesus paved the way for that eternal life through his passion, death, and resurrection. He gave us that hope of eternal life, hope of immortality, right? And that's what we say in the preface in the Mass, Lord, for your faithful, life is not ended, it is changed. Know that the death is only just opens, it is like a key that opens the doors of eternal life. I'm a friend in Christ Jesus. For us to enter into that kingdom of God, you and I have to live that gospel as Tony and Sarah lived. I'm sure they have shared all their love to the family, and they have planted the seeds of faith into your hearts, and therefore you are also keeping that faith in your life. And you should continue to keep that faith until the end of your life, as your parents kept their faith until the end of their life. And you should always take them as a model for your marital life, for your family life, as they are good mother, a good father, as they are faithful, honest to one another, and they kept the God in their life. So also you should always Remind yourself that the example and the model that your parents have given to you. Only then we live up to their expectations. Only then we become a pleasing children in the sight of God and to your parents. My friends in Christ Jesus, as we all gather together this morning to entrust their souls into the hands of God, let us pray with faith that they may enjoy eternal bliss in the kingdom of God. And our responsibility as children, as a family members, as a friends and relatives, by attending the funeral mass is not over. We need to continue to keep praying for them, offer masses for them, that they would enjoy eternal bliss in the kingdom of God. My friends in Christ Jesus, we all of us one day will depart from this world, right? None of us are permanent in this world. We came into this world with nothing and we leave this world with nothing. Only just we carry all the good deeds that we have done, all the good actions, all the good things that we have done, we carry with us to that eternal kingdom of God, right? And as we all remind ourselves that we are all not the permanent people in this world. We only have a temporary house that we have built in this world. And that temporary house also will be over, and we have to leave that eternal home, eternal house that God has prepared to each and every one of us in his eternal kingdom. That's what Jesus tells in John's Gospel. No? I am going to my Father's house. There are many dwelling places. And I will come back again, and I will take you where I am going to be. Right? That is the wish, that is the desire of God the Father, that is the desire of Jesus Christ, that you and I have to meet with him at the end of our life. Right? How can we acquire that one? Only when we keep God in our life, just as Tony and Sara did in their life. Let us pray that they may enjoy eternal bliss in the kingdom of God together, and that may we also one day see them share the eternal bliss in the kingdom of God. Amen. Thank you all once again for being here and praying for the family and being with the family and praying for the eternal rest of Tony and Sarah. God bless you.
Please stand.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. Let your response be, Lord, hear our prayers.
For Tony and Sarah, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that they both may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the family and friends of Tony and Sarah, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who are burdened by their loss may be blessed with courage, strength, patience, and understanding, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for all those who have died in the hope of rising again. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all gathered here, Christians everywhere, that we may live in the bonds of peace and charity, witnessing the love of the Eternal Father, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those special intentions that we hold in the privacy of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Let us pray. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the vices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servants, Tony and Sara Zendejas, we beseech your mercy that they who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, the sending down of your Spirit upon them with due form, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly in this fashion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and my own bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Tony and Sarah's in the house, whom you have called from this life, from this world to yourself. Grant that they who did not doubt, they who were united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy, as all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Patrick, Saint Anthony, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through our Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily prayer, and and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, through the kingdom, the power, and glory of yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins and the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Please do stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Tony, our sister Sara, may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. My dear brothers and sisters, it has been very hard for the family as they have lost their mom, dad, grandma, and grandpa. It's very hard, difficult, these difficult times. But you know, they have journeyed together and they have journeyed to eternal life together again. That's a great blessing, not all the couples get that such opportunity, right? And let us continue to pray for their eternal rest, and also thank you all for being here, and especially being in the family. My deepest hearty condolences to all of you once again. We will keep you all in our prayers, and let us always keep God in our life as Tony and Sarah did in their life, and also Mary, our mother, in our life. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Tony, our sister Sarah. May our farewell express our affection for them. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet them again in the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, We commend our sister Tony and our sister Sarah Zendejas in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, they will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon